Congressman Tom Perriello is a Democrat who spends a lot of time listening to conservatives.
Our president yesterday is prepared to jack up our kids for another $50 billion.
Perriello was the comeback kid of 2008. Down more than 30 points in early fall, he came back in a strong Republican district against a longtime incumbent to win what became the closest race in the country.
I didn't get into this to play tiddlywinks, you know, this is a serious battle.
Some critics may call him names, but lazy is not among them. During the health care debate, Perriello held more town hall meetings than any other member of Congress. The pro-life Catholic had early concerns about abortion language in the bill, but in the end, he voted yes. He also voted for the stimulus and cap and trade. Their votes Perriello defends. But his Republican challenger, State Senator Robert Hurt, says they're proof he's a rubber stamp for the liberal agenda.
Tom Perriello, he's their congressman, not ours.
The obligation of any representative is to stand up for your people, regardless of who in Washington or who in Richmond may be banging on you otherwise.
Robert Hurt's Virginia roots and political ties run deep. He attends the same Presbyterian church his family has gone to for generations, and he has a decade of elected political experience in local and state office. A third candidate, Jeff Clark, who's running as an independent conservative, hasn't gained traction in the polls.
This election, at the end of the day, is about whether or not we want to return to those principles that made this country great, or do we want to go in the direction of Europe and Greece, and watch the dismantling of the greatest country on earth.
Perriello's view of the world is colored by his passion for service, born out of his Catholic roots. He started several faith-based organizations before serving in Congress and is a social justice Christian to the core, a brand that's recently come under fire by Glenn Beck.
I know that Jesus speaks overwhelmingly of caring for the least among us, and you can't just edit that out of the Bible.
He's got incumbency on his behalf, and he's worked very hard. But swimming against a wave is very, very tough. The odds are a lot of congressmen in Perriello's position will be drowned.
A recent poll conducted by the Hill newspaper found the race in a dead heat, with Hurt beating Perriello by a single point and 9% of likely voters undecided. Other polls, like this one conducted by Roanoke College, show Hurt with a more comfortable lead.
Along with America's political realities, Virginia's 5th District reflects her economic ones, too. Here along the North Carolina border, some communities are experiencing an unemployment rate of more than 20%. That's double the national average. And for years now, lawmakers from both parties have had a hard time figuring out just how to put those people back to work.
There has to be a reason for a business to locate there. If you just try to do it by throwing every tax break at them, they're going to be there as long as the breaks exist, and then they're going to head out.
The federal government is spending $1.7 trillion in deficit spending. It's borrowing $13 trillion from places like China and Japan. And that sort of spending absolutely has an effect on business.
Hurt says Perriello is out of touch with Main Street Virginia. Perriello says he's just hitting his stride inside the Beltway. But if it doesn't work out for him in November, the incumbent says he'll pray about it and find a new way to serve.
One of the promises I made to my father when I got into this was that I would always remember that Judgment Day is more important than Election Day.
Hurt hopes Tea Party and other activists will keep fighting for conservative principles long after Election Day.
We've got to get it right this time, and the Republicans have got to demonstrate that they can lead.
In the meantime, the battle continues over the airwaves and on the ground. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, reporting from Virginia's 5th District.